Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to the second session on government schemes. So a lot of students were asking me, sir, please have some sessions on government schemes in terms of MCQs and their explanations so that we understand what kind of questions can be asked from scheme section. So I decided to come out with a total of 5 sessions where I will be discussing a total of 25 questions from government schemes as well as some amendments in acts that have been made, which will give you a very fair idea about the kinds of questions that can be asked in the examination and will help you in studying better. So let us start with the second session. The first question for today is from Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana PMAY CLSS Credit Linked Subsidy Scheme. Okay. The question says the carpet area for loans under Credit Linked Subsidy Scheme, which is a vertical of PMAY, was 90 square meter for MIG 1 and 110 square meter for MIG 2, minimum income group, at the time of launch of the scheme. In 2008, the carpet area was increased for both MIG 1 and MIG 2. What is the answer for this? If you know the answer, provide it in the comment section below or keep it to yourself, does not matter, and see whether you are able to answer it correctly or not. The answer to this question is D. It has now been increased to 160 square meter for MIG 1 and 200 square meter for MIG 2. What are the other conditions? It is 30 square meter for economically weaker sections, 60 square meter for LIG or low income group, and 160 square meter and 200 square meter for MIG 1 and MIG 2. We'll have some more questions on Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana as well. It's a home loan scheme for urban poor, which was Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban, as well as for rural poor. It was launched in the year 2015. They are provided home loan interest subsidy on purchase or construction or extension or improvement of their house. So if you already have a house, or if you want to purchase a house, or if you have purchased a plot of land, you want to construct the house, you are provided home loan interest subsidy. You can take a home loan. Whatever interest you have to pay, you will be provided subsidy on that loan. Okay, so that is the primary purpose of PMAY. The second question is, in the final budget 2019-20, an additional deduction amount is declared on interest on loans borrowed under affordable housing PMAY. What is the amount of deduction? The answer is B, 1.5 lakh. Affordable housing or low cost housing is a scheme in which people with low income varied by local or national governments are offered houses at cheaper prices. You need to pay some interest on the loans that you take. So interest paid on home loans is allowed a deduction to the extent of rupees 2 lakh. In the final budget in 2019-20, an additional deduction of rupees 1.5 lakh was announced on loans borrowed up to 31st March 2020. So these are the important things that you need to remember. And the affordable houses valued should be valued up to rupees 45 lakh. So if there is a affordable house up to rupees 45 lakh, you take it, you buy it, whatever interest you're providing, you're giving on the loan that you've taken on that particular house, you're provided a deduction of 2 lakh before, now an additional deduction of 1.5 lakh. Okay. The interest deduction will be subject to condition that the loan has to be sanctioned during the current fiscal only, that is up to 31st March 2020. And the home buyer should not have a previous residential property in his name on the date of sanction of loan. Third question on PM Awas Yojana, which is on Grameen, had set a target to build 1 crore or 10 million or 100 lakh houses for rural poor by the year 2019. A new target has been created to build how many houses by 2022 as set in final budget 2019-20 under this scheme? The answer to this question is A, 1.95 crore. So the new target is to be able to build 1.95 crore houses by 2022. Okay. What is the main goal? Housing for all by 2022. Now PMAY Grameen has increased its target to 1.95 crore dwellings till 2022. Okay. The fourth question is on Stand Up India scheme. The Stand Up India scheme was launched in 2018 to support entrepreneurship among women and marginalized segments of the society. Till when is the is the scheme, Stand Up India scheme, being extended. So this was launched in the year 2016 and now this has been extended till 2025. So 2020 to 2025. It was launched on 5th April 2016 as part of government's efforts to support entrepreneurship among women and SCST communities. The scheme is anchored by Department of Financial Services, DFS. What is the primary purpose of Stand Up India scheme? Giving loans to entrepreneurs. Facilitate bank loans between 10 lakh and 1 crore to at least one scheduled caste or scheduled tribe or woman borrower for setting up any greenfield or a new enterprise. Okay. In the new budget, the scheme got extension till the year 2020-2025. So remember the amount of loan, the limit of loan between 10 lakh and 1 crore. Who all are eligible? Women borrower, scheduled caste, scheduled tribe. What is the extension? 2025. When was it launched? 5th April 2016. Which organization is the anchor of this scheme? Department of Financial Services. Why? Because they are helping in providing loans. Let's come to the last question for today. It is on interest subvention program. To encourage women entrepreneurship, women's self-help group interest subvention program has been expanded. What is the new reach of the expansion? Now, this has been expanded to all districts. Before this, it was available to all aspirational districts. Now, interest subvention program is a provision under Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana, National Rural Livelihoods Mission. And the purpose is to provide subsidy on the loans or the interest of loans being given by the women self-help groups. So under this, a woman self-help group, if it takes a loan amount of up to 3 lakh, has to give interest of 7% only, and whatever is the difference is given by the or paid by the government to the bank. If they end up paying well in time, they are provided additional interest subvention of 3%. So in turn, the effective rate of interest comes down to 4%. Now this has been expanded to all the districts. It was not available in all the districts. Now it has been expanded to all the districts of the entire country. Okay, so this is the recent amendment. Therefore, a question can be asked from this area or any other area related to Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana, NRLM or interest subvention program under DAY. So these were the questions for today for session 2 of government schemes as well as amendments made in different acts and laws. Please keep following the channel for more such videos. I will be coming out with a total of 5 sessions, post which I will create something new for helping the students preparing for this year's examination of RBI as well as SEBI. All the very best. Take care and subscribe to the channel.